Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to make oven-baked pork chops with homestyle gravy. So let's start with our pork chops. What I have here is a pack of three pork chops that I bought from my supermarket. And these weigh 1.25 or 1.25 pounds. So that means each one of these is roughly 6 to 7 ounces. So it's a good size for pork chops. And they have been trimmed to some degree. There's still a rim of fat around the outside. I'm not going to take that off before I cook it. I'm going to go ahead and season them, and then I have some flour here that I will be dredging them in, and then I will be cooking them in an iron skillet on top of the stove until they're brown, and then I'll be baking them in the oven. But when I finish and get ready to make my gravy, I'll be pouring off all the grease. So if you see all this fat that you know will turn into grease, believe me, it will disappear before we make our gravy. So let's start by seasoning these. And I use meat tenderizer, the unseasoned variety. That means there are no spices added in addition to salt, but they are salted by this shaking of meat tenderizer. So just get the tops and the bottoms of these. These look like they're about 3/4 of an inch thick, but when you're baking in the oven, you can just kind of look in, turn them over if you feel like it, but you know when they're done. If you have any question, you can always stick a fork in the center and then use a knife to cut through and see if it is white meat, not red or pink, and you do need to cook pork all the way through, fully cook it. All right, I've got those seasoned, so I'm just gonna open this Ziploc bag. There is about 1 cup of flour in here. I didn't really measure it, I just did it by eyesight. And I'm going to turn on my peanut oil. I put about 1/4 cup in here, and I've already heated it, but I turned this off, so I need to bring that up to the point where it can receive these pork chops. So let's put them one at a time. They're kind of large. Sometimes I do two at a time, but with these being fairly large, I think just one at a time. And we'll see if that oil is ready. Yeah, it's kind of bubbling a little bit. You don't want to put this into cold oil. So if you can see it just simmer a little bit, then you know that it's going to be okay. So it should sizzle just a tiny bit when you put it in there. If it doesn't, then you're starting with it too cold, so wait on the next one. But I think these will be fine by the time I get to that third one. When you get those in there, what you're gonna need to do is pepper them. I just like the regular ground black pepper. You can do both sides if you like, or just put plenty on one side. I think we're just gonna get the top side here. So that's looking good. And what I need is a fork. I'm about to crank, so grabbing a fork so I can turn these. These really don't need to be terribly brown. If you want to brown them nicely, that's fine. But they just need to have had contact with that oil. And you see there's a little bit of brown where that fat is. Actually, it's where it will brown the most easily. Just turn them over so that both sides have had contact with the oil, and then you're ready to go to the oven with them. I'm going to grab something here to protect my hands, because this is hot. And turn this off. The oven is preheated to 400 degrees, so we're going to let this cook probably half hour. So I'll be coming back to let you know how long it took when they get done. I've been checking my pork chops quite a bit, and it's been slightly over 20 minutes, so it didn't take the entire 30 minutes, but you can see them right there, and they look done, and I think they're ready to come out of the oven. So you can see that they look very white, and I will cut into one in just a minute to show you. So I'm going to bring this out of the oven and take it across the room and come back and close that oven door. The oven turned off, and then what I want to do is to get those pork chops immediately out of that oil. And I normally put it on paper towel. Here I'm just going to shake them a bit because this is really for demonstration purposes. I'll pat them in a few minutes with a paper towel to get as much of the excess oil off. But see how nice and pretty those pork chops have come out? We'll put that aside for a moment. It'll be on a nice serving dish, and we'll turn our attention to making the gravy. So the gravy that I'm going to make is going to be based on the pan drippings. You remember there was quite a bit of fat on those pork chops, so there's probably some grease from the pork chops as well as some of the peanut oil that I started out with. So I have a little jar, just a mayonnaise jar. Keep those jars under my sink all the time for me to be able to pour off grease. And I pour every drop of grease off that I possibly can get. So the gravy that I make is just about as low fat as you can make. So there we go with all of that fat poured off. And then coming back to the stove, but I'm not turning it on yet. I'm going to take some of the flour that was in the shaker bag. It had about a cup in there. Take about half a cup and put it in here. And what we're going to do is get a spoon. And we need some liquid in there. So let's start with water. I've got a couple of cups of water here. We're going to need some water and also some milk. So I'm just going to use this water, 2 cups right now, in order to be able to blend that flour and also get the crust off the bottom, because that's where the flavor is going to come from. So I want to stir that around, and as I stir it, I want to get all of that good flavor off the sides and bottom. It is important to mash those flour lumps so that you don't have lumpy gravy, but this gravy should come out as smooth and velvety as you can imagine when we get finished with it. The next thing I'm going to add is some milk, and I have 1 cup of milk. This is just skim milk measured here. I'm going to pour that whole cup in. And then I'm going to put this over heat. Now I'll continue to stir and get after those pieces of flour in there so we won't have lumps. But I'll be working on this, and as it progresses, I may need to add more water. It's basically got everything it needs except a little seasoning here. Let me put some salt on it. Just a shake to taste of salt. And then my job now, after turning it on, is just to stir and scrape. And I do that continuously until it's bubbly and done. So I'll be back and show you what it looks like in just a minute, and I'll tell you if I added any more water. Homestyle gravy is done. You can see it's nice and bubbly. It has a wonderful texture. I don't need to add any more water. I didn't add any as it was cooking. So it was just as it was when I left you. I'm going to come over here and pour some of this into a gravy boat. Won't be able to fit all of it, but just pour some down there. And you can see part of what I have planned for dinner tonight is sitting right here. Here's the pork chop. Let me just cut down and show you the nice center that you have there. All done, all the way completely through. When you want to serve that up, just put a pork chop on your plate, and then that nice gravy you might want to put over the top of it. Or if you have mashed potatoes, which I normally would have with this, I would put it on my mashed potatoes. And then earlier in the day, I did these red candy cinnamon apples, baked apples. Or cooked apples, and they are cool to room temperature. They're maybe lukewarm. That's a good time to serve them, and they look beautiful and taste great with a dish like pork chops. So that's at least the beginning of our meal for tonight, and I hope you like it.